A blustery day on the plains of Kansas, but perfect conditions inside Charles Cook Arena. We welcome you to Wichita, Kansas for today's American Athletic Conference women's basketball matchup featuring the visiting Memphis Tigers and the Wichita State Shockers. Both teams looking for their first victory in conference, and it should be a good one. Alongside head coach Angela Beck, I'm Kit McConico. So glad to have you with us. Coach, two young teams, both looking for their first win in the American.
You don't want to say that they're desperate, but they're both 0-2, and this is a desperate game. Neither team is shooting the ball very well here at the beginning, and neither team is great on the boards right now. So they're going to try to fight for the rebounds and shoot the ball well tonight.
Now take a look at your keys for this matchup first for the visitors.
Well, the Tigers, they've got to hit some shots. They've had some open shots. They just can't hit them. And then they need to get the ball to their post players because that's when they're most productive and have a positive mentality.
Now the keys for the Shockers.
Well, rebound the ball. That's what coach wants them to do. She said, say a prayer that we rebound. So I just want to, she always wants them to play hard and want it, but they've got to rebound tonight.
Here are your key players for the game. First, for the Tigers, well, Jamyra Suits, the freshman guard, has been outstanding this season.
Well, she's been outstanding because she's the number one freshman in the American Athletic Conference. She has the body to sustain this kind of game as a freshman. She can take you in, she can take you out, and she can rebound with the big girls.
And your key player for the Shockers, another freshman, Carla Brimont from France.
These freshmen are both leading their teams. She's an unorthodox player. She's going to bring that international flavor. She's 5'10", and she can hit that open jumper, and she has a lot of confidence. When she's open, she's going to fire it up.
Both teams looking for their first victory in the American. We'll have the Tigers and the Shockers coming up for you next on the American Digital Network.
In a city known for doing things our way, there's a university that's driven to do the same, to blur the outdated line between academic pursuits and active ones, not just to learn, but to experience, to create, solve, build, to explore and express, to lead. Because an education isn't something you get, it's something you do.
Here in Wichita, moments away from tip-off, and we take a look at the starting lineups for the Tigers and the Shockers. Jasmine Herndon, Taylor Barnes, Kiana Coomber, and as we mentioned, one of the key players, Jamyra Schutz, Elena Davis rounding out the starters for the Tigers. Serena Losada-Cabbage, Carla Brimont, Raven Prince, one of the leaders for the Shockers, Jada Hampton, and Serafini Bastin, the starters for Wichita State. We now go down courtside to check in with the third member of our broadcast crew, sideline reporter John Kurtz.
According to Memphis head coach Melissa McFerrin, tonight the key is about shot selection. She wants her team to make sure to get the ball inside and not rely too much on the three-point shot. On the other side for Wichita State and Keitha Adams, rebounding is the key word. Rebounding is so important tonight, the team can either take away or earn more sprints. They're already 20 in debt from being out-rebounded by 20 last time out. 8 rebounds tonight for a Shocker means an automatic start coming up next game. Kit?
Sean. Ready for the opening tip. Both these teams looking for their first victory in conference, looking to get on a win streak. The Tigers have lost the last 3, the Shockers the last 2. Coach, so important to get off to a good start early in this one.
Well, both of them are going to have to shore up their defenses. It'll be interesting to see the matchups that they have in the interior.
Opening tip taken by the Shockers, and they will have the first possession.
Memphis likes to come out in a man-to-man on a miss and a 3-2 zone on a make.
Herndon with the rebound off the Bastin miss. Tigers quickly the other way. Herndon still. Tigers setting things up over in the hands of Barnes. Barnes unable to connect. Shockers underneath and another miss inside the putback. Basket and the foul. Wichita State with the opener.
Well, it's Raven Prince going back and getting it with her quick ups, up and down. She's going to make a friend out of her coach right there. She might have gotten away with a little travel, but good effort there on the boards.
Prince, the 6'1 redshirt junior forward out of Oklahoma City from Millwood High School.
Gotcha. So if you get 8 rebounds, you get to start the next game. So she's got, what, 2 now? I'd be counting them.
That is one of second-year head coach Keith Adams' policies. If you get 8 rebounds or more, an automatic start in the next game.
So one thing Melissa did talk about was getting the ball inside. They took a 3 right off the bat, so probably not the way she wanted to start. There's another 3.
Unable to knock it down. Rebound to the Shockers, pushing it up the front court. Hampton unable to connect from long range. Bastin there with the rebound.
For two teams that are struggling from the three-point line, they're firing it up here early.
Remon off the back of the iron. Rebound to the Tigers.
Tigers like to push transition as much as they can, and then they run a little secondary break. Wichita State's looking to pack it in. They know they want to try to hit those posts.
Looking for Davis underneath. Has 6 double-doubles on the season. A lot of contact. No whistle. As Losada Cabbage comes away with the rebound. Quickly into the front court. Able to find Hampton. Jada Hampton with the bucket.
I like Jada Hampton. She really squared up strong to the basket and finished.
Davis mentioned the 6 double-doubles. Had a difficult 2 games to start conference. And out of bounds, had a foot on the baseline, did Elena Davis.
When Davis gets it in the short corner, they're really trying to push her out of bounds. And 2 times she did take that baseline corner. So good defense.
Melissa McFerrin, 11 years the head coach of the Tigers, 3rd winningest coach in program history.
Well, she's been around the block a few times. She has resurrected this program and taken him to postseason play. So she is a legend there.
He's had some good recruiting classes. 3rd best recruiting class in the American in 2018, and a bright future. They have a very impressive class coming in next year. The best recruiting class under her direction. 4 4-star recruits, 1 3-star headed to Bluff City.
What I'm impressed with about that kid is they come from Memphis. 3 of those players are on her roster right now are from Memphis. She doesn't have to go too far away.
A lot of local talent there in Memphis and surrounding areas as Tigers able to get on the board. Coach, you mentioned the 3-point shooting early on. Neither able to hit from long range.
Well, it's been their nemesis this year, and both coaches know that they're struggling shooting.
And the foul will be charged on Bastin. There's her head coach, Keitha Adams, 2nd year in charge of the Shockers. Picked up her 300th career victory earlier this season.
Hard-nosed, kind of old-school coach. She's adding up the sprints they're going to have to do every time they miss a rebound opportunity. You don't mess with Keitha Adams.
The motto of her Shockers, go and get it. What she kept reiterating to you and I was, it's about rebounding. We have to play more physical. We have to go up and get the ball off the glass.
Well, then she got a little religious on us by asking us to pray. I mean, she wanted us literally, she said, is there anything that you want from us? And she said, yeah, will you pray that my team rebounds? And so.
Underneath, Porter draws the foul. Brianna Porter, the senior from Nashville.
Brianna Porter, she's a force inside. I like it when they go to her. She also leads the team in blocks this year with 14 blocks.
Porter, the 6'3 senior forward out of the University School of Nashville. Changes coming for the Shockers as they will bring on Asia Henderson, the 6'3 redshirt freshman from North Carolina.
I think when you have trouble shooting the basketball, it's really good to put the dribble drive down and attack more. And I do like Memphis coming in transition. I'd like to see Wichita push it down the floor a little bit more.
Bremont able to get out of trouble into the hands of Baston, the native of Belgium.
Here's that 3-2 matchup we talked about earlier that Memphis likes to do on a make.
The three ball coming. Hampton unable to knock it down, out of bounds off the Shockers. It'll be Tigers' ball. Coach, we mentioned the shooting percentage. Both head coaches would like to see that notched up a considerable amount. Are you surprised with the three-point attempts early on?
I'm totally surprised, especially with Memphis and how much she talked about the fact she didn't. That's what she wants right there. I mean, she's got a good double low post down there, and she wants to hammer it inside. But, yes, I am surprised Memphis is letting it fire.
Well, that's what they're looking for. Elena Davis, the sophomore forward out of Augusta, Georgia, draws the foul and heads to the line to shoot two.
Well, Davis is 20th in scoring in the American and 8th in rebounding. So when you can get someone to score and then also do the dirty work, I call her a player.
And of Cross Creek High School, able to tie it up at 4. 5:37 remaining in the first.
Well, it's not going to be a high-scoring contest. I think we've figured that out already. Neither team puts a lot of points on the board.
Brema drives in. The native of Angers, France, hits the runner on the baseline.
Well, that's an intelligent play by Brema. I mean, she passes up the outside shot, takes it off the drive, and runs a little floater in there.
Davis back in the low block and headed back to the free throw line is Elena Davis. That will be charged to Sabrina Losada Cabbage, her first.
I think that's a girl with a purpose right there. She gets the ball, turns, puts it on the ball on the ground, and takes it to the rack. She's a strong girl.
Davis, just a sophomore, already impacting this one as Raven Prince comes off for Wichita State.
Coach talked about maybe who's improved or maybe surprised her a little bit, and she went right to Davis. She said without her doing some of the things she's done this year, we'd be in more trouble.
And she said it's been a tough start to conference play for Davis. Really looking for her to find that form that she had early on.
Well, they're doubling, tripling her. There's no surprises anymore.
Raymond able to come up with it. Shot deflected and then turned over. Tigers into the front court. A miss from short end. Baston with the rebound. Still Baston. And the foul will send Asia Henderson to the line for the Shockers.
One of the emphases that Melissa McFerrin has on for her team is to finish layups. You know, and that was not a finish on that end.
We head down courtside to check in with John.
All of you out there watching on the American Digital Network and on Facebook, we want to hear from you. Let us know where you're watching the game from. We want you to comment along with the game, watch your team. We want you to be involved here on the American Digital Network and on Facebook today. So again, comment throughout the game and let us know where you're watching the game from today. Kit?
Sean, we're feeling we're going to have some people from all over the world, all the nations represented on the Shockers roster. We'll take a break. Tied at 6, 4:31 remaining in the first.
This is our game, our moment, our time. We work hard and play harder. We stay loyal to the game and to our team. We are Power, American Power, the American Power. powered by determination.
Dominance for a fourth straight year.
Wichita from 30!
Unbelievable!
And be able to celebrate this type of championship.
There's the record breaker! They are the champions of the American.
Shocker fans enjoying themselves here at Coke Arena. Tied at 6 early on in this one. Both teams looking for their first victory in conference. Glad to have you with us here on the American Digital Network. Wherever you may be joining us from, I have a feeling people joining us from across the world. 5 international players on that Shockers roster. Poland, France, Belgium, Switzerland, all represented. Coach, tie ball game early on. What stands out to you?
Well, what stands out is both coaches talked about getting good shots, and they need to hit shots, and so far that's not what we're seeing. 1 of 5 from 2-point for Memphis, and 0 for 2 from 3-point, and then 3 for 12 for Wichita, and 0 for 5 from 3-point range. So, you know, what bothers me is that these are wide open shots. I mean, these are great looks. These aren't really bad shots. It's just they're one and done, and they're not hitting their open shots.
And neither team shooting better than 25% from the field. Neither has been able to knock down a 3-pointer thus far. Combined 0 of 7.
So if I'm Memphis, I'm just going to say, hey, keep ball reversing it, hitting our short corner and tacking in the post. And I think Wichita needs a little better ball movement, too. They're kind of getting caught on one side of the floor and just getting stuck there.
Asia Henderson, the 6'3 redshirt freshman center from Hope Mills, North Carolina, at the line, goes 1 of 2, puts the Shockers up by a point.
Here's some urgency. I was going to say I don't feel any urgency from either team, but I like this look here.
Driving in, Davis underneath. A lot of contact, unable to get her own rebound, but it will stay with the Tigers as Henderson was last to touch it. And it appears that the Tigers starting to find number 33 down low.
Well, I'm pretty sure if we were in that timeout huddle, she was asking them to attack the post here. I like Davis, though. She's really showing her strength in there.
Both teams making changes. Breebaugh coming off for the Shockers. Davis for the Tigers. Underneath, good look. Shoots, unable to come up with anything.
Quick double down by Wichita State. That's one thing Coach talked about when they get the ball to the post, that they are going to double down, so they have to expect that, keep the ball up, and reverse it.
4 minutes remaining in the first quarter. We head back down to courtside to check in with John Kurtz.
Well, guys, with Elena Davis right now inside, Memphis has been able to get the ball to her early on and has scored. But right now, Melissa McFerrin wants her to just take it up with some more strength, some more authority. And that's been a focus in practice. Obviously, Melissa McFerrin feels like Davis has made things too complicated inside so far.
Benson with the basket. Thank you, John. That's one thing Coach Melissa McFerrin told us. Coach, he said it was focused on finishing inside against contact.
Well, we can't ignore that three that just was made for the first three of the game with Jada Stinson in the deep corner. She's a feisty guard, and she stretches the floor when she gets in there.
First made three coming from the sophomore from Kentucky. A battle on the floor, tied up. Stinson hoping her three will spark the offense for the Tigers.
Yeah, neither of these teams have the personnel to extend 94 feet. So most of us coming in the quarter court, and they're both kind of zone oriented.
Henderson unable to knock down the turnaround. Back to Stinson, looking for another three, in and out. Tigers with the rebound and the putback. Jasmine James, the senior from Ontario.
Yeah, Jasmine James is she's the cleanup woman. I mean, she gets in there and gives them a few boards every game.
Canadian extends the Tigers' lead 11-7. Davis back on the floor. And here come the Tigers. A good look, but unable to finish. A missed opportunity for Memphis.
I think that's their second missed, you know, pretty much uncontested layup.
Reed now up with Ambrogio. Shockers looking for anything. Tigers the other way in transition and able to hit from close in is Jasmine Herndon. And a timeout, a minute 52 remaining in the first. Memphis has extended their lead, now up to six. Take a look at the standings in the American Athletic Conference. First, another look at the basket extending the Tigers' lead. And here are the standings and the usual suspects atop, as you might imagine. An upcoming broadcast we'll have for you here on the American Digital Network. We'll be back with you on Wednesday. Shockers back in action, headed down south to Dallas to take on the Mustangs of SMU. Tulane and USF on Saturday, and then mark your calendars for the following week. UCF at ECU. Big games coming up the foreseeable future here on the American Digital Network. Always glad to have your company.
Well, last couple times up and down, I liked what Memphis did. They clearly were getting up and down the floor better than Wichita State, so they need to keep pushing tempo.
Great look underneath, a bounce pass to Losada Cabbage, the senior from Santa Fe, New Mexico, able to finish.
That's the first touch that she's had, and she needs a lot more.
Davis, unable to get the putback off the miss.
I guess if I'm going to talk to Davis in my huddle, I'm going to say slow down. She doesn't need to hurry. She's out quicking herself. Take your time, because no one's taking that ball from you.
Davis, all kinds of power underneath, but rushed the last shot. Memphis back with it after the Shockers turnover. Well off the mark. Rebounded by Fay that time. Now the other way. Losada Cabbage unable to hit the three in transition, but Shockers retain possession.
I'll take Cabbage taking that shot all day. That's where she really helped him last year, and she's just not getting that opportunity this year because she's underneath so much more.
Good pass underneath. Unselfish. Able to find Stinson, who finishes for the Tigers.
Well, that's not looking good for Wichita State. They need to get back in transition quickly. They're sending four to the boards. They want to get offensive rebounds, but they're getting beat in transition for easy buckets. So you're going to have to release some people and stop this transition game because this is too easy.
Another Shockers turnover. Stinson thought about the step back three. The Tigers will hold for the final shot of the quarter. Davis.
Outquicked yourself. She's frustrated, but that's on her.
That will do it for the first quarter. Memphis leading Wichita State 15-9. We'll be back here to Coke Arena for quarter number two on the American Digital Network after this.
More than 7,000 student athletes rising to become champions in 22 different sports at 13 esteemed institutions across 11 states. 360,000 students and 2.6 million alumni rise up in celebration of a Power Six conference known as the American. powered by determination.
Strong in mind, strong in body, strong in school, sport, life.
The grind is 10% physical and 90% mental.
The mind is the power.
The body is the means to jump higher, run faster,
be smarter, and live longer.
There is no weakness when it comes to seeking help.
We are stronger together.
So let's talk about it.
A waterfall starts with one drop.
Change starts with one person.
The American is dedicated to ending the stigma related to mental health.
And promoting success through a healthy, powerful mind.
Promoting success through a healthy, powerful mind.
Tigers lead the Shockers 15-9 as we head to the second quarter. Both teams looking to improve the shooting. Memphis doing a very good job there at the end of the quarter, able to extend their lead as we now take a look at the standings in the American Athletic Conference. The usual suspects atop the table.
Pretty much, except for Tulane and Tulsa. They haven't been up there for a while, so that's exciting to see them emerge in the top half and undefeated.
UConn, UCF, Tulane, Tulsa, all undefeated. Coach, your thoughts on the first quarter? What stands out to you?
Well, what stands out is what we knew coming into the game, that they're just not shooting the ball very well. Both teams are struggling to shoot maybe 30%. Rebound, we thought maybe that might be a difference maker. They're pretty even in that. But I think that Memphis has established an inside game a little better, and they've gotten out in transition, so the Shockers need to pick it up a little bit.
Again, we want to know where you are watching from. We know we have all kinds of viewers from across the world, and so glad to have you with us this afternoon. So let us know on Facebook where you are watching from. Ready to get underway for quarter number two.
Well, 15-9, not a lot of points here. You know, you like to see teams score in the 20s, 25 points in the first quarter, get the game going. So we just need more energy, more sense of urgency, especially off of Wichita side. I know they're a young team, but they have to play a little bit harder.
Shocker shooting just 22%, 4 of 18 from the field. And immediately on cue, Tigers right down to Davis, who draws the foul.
That's one thing that Melissa wanted to do, is get the high-low game going from the top. She didn't really want to feed from the wing as much. That was a great touch pass. But once again, she needs to jump stop, clear everybody out, and finish that shot. She's just a little quick.
Davis now 4 of 5 from the line. All of her points have come from the charity stripe.
Yeah, Melissa wants her Memphis team to just trust the process. And she keeps talking about the process, and she feels like she has gotten effort even though they've lost early. So I think that's a big key, that they are playing hard, but she wants them to play a little smarter.
Davis hits them both, extends the Tigers' lead to 18, their largest of the ball game. Shockers really trying to get something going offensively.
I think overloading the baseline versus this 3-2 defense is the way to go.
Out of bounds. Faye unable to get anything going and came off the hands of Serafini Bastin. It'll be Tigers ball.
Well, I like it. They totally tilted him over there. They had the high low going. She should have finished that. I mean, taking it underneath and trying to pass it weak side. They worked so hard to get the ball to her. You know, she just needs to take it.
Shockers have doubled the Tigers in turnovers, 6-3. Long two. Shockers come up with the rebound and quickly into the front court. Pass batted away. Tigers with it. Davis pulls down the rebound. Davis unable to get it on the second chance.
I'm going to say she cannot buy a basket.
Right now, both teams having trouble knocking anything down. Bastin wisely pulling it out. Now Bastin to the hoop. Draws the foul from Melania Rudy White.
That's the first time I've seen them try to penetrate this zone. And that was a good take by her. So a little bit more of that, a little more aggressiveness.
Davis 0 of 6 from the field. As Baston hits the first.
Starts playing with your head when you start missing like that. I mean, her effort's obviously there, but now she's just getting frustrated.
Serafini Baston, the freshman point guard from Belgium. Hits both free throws and makes it a 6-point game. Shoots, trying to set things up.
Pretty physical in there against Davis.
Shoots a lot of contacts, and the whistle will send Jamyra Shoots to the line. The foul will be charged to Carla Bremaw.
Bremaw was selling it right here. She, look at her, she's selling it, that, oh, this is a charge. But didn't quite get it, but.
Jamyra Shoots, the freshman from Brownsville, Tennessee, out of Haywood High School. What a high school career she had, over 3,000 points scored. But unable to hit, it remains a 6-point game. Bremaw for three. And another miss. Shockers now 0 of 8 from long range. Underneath to a wide open Davis and easily lays it up and in.
I like it when the big girl runs the floor hard and then you reward her by getting her the pass. And she finished that time, so that's a good transition there.
Davis with her first made field goal of the contest. And thrown away, another turnover. And blocked, Bremaw swats away the shot from Shoots. The turnovers continue for the Shockers.
Yeah, just the tempo is just a little faster than they wanted to go, and they just bobbled it, you know. Young teams do that a lot, and they don't value the possession.
9 turnovers by Wichita State. Davis, great entry pass from Jones. Davis, no trouble.
That was a nice touch pass by Jones.
Now a double-digit lead for the Tigers.
Yep, there's that travel that we've been talking about pregame. She just needs to fire it up. Even, I mean, she's one girl, I would just say keep shooting, Bremaw, because she has a great three-point shot. But at some point, the shooter's got to keep shooting and hit one.
10th turnover of the ball game for the Shockers. Not doing themselves any favors. Shooting just 20% from the field combined with the 10 turnovers.
Well, 11 points just isn't going to make it.
The other way, hard to the hoop. Jasmine Herndon extends the Tigers' lead.
Well, that's the first that we've seen Herndon go attack the basket.
Local product out of Douglas High School in Memphis. Bremaw draws the foul and will head to the line.
Well, she didn't feel good with her three, so she shot faked it and got that little floater that she hits most of the time. And smart play by Bremaw.
James with the foul, her first.
I think the problem for the Shockers is they don't have an interior game. They don't have anyone that's willing to score. So it's really basically Bremaw, and everyone else is just kind of role-playing it.
Coach, you mentioned Wichita State getting caught up in the Tigers' game plan. The Tigers clearly want to play fast. They want to play in transition. That is not the Shockers' game plan.
No, it's not. It's not how they play best, but they're just a little flat. And I think Coach knows this, and you should have energy when you're young.
Inside, unable to hit the circus shot, Shoots. Baston, a great pass up ahead to Hampton.
I'd say great hands by Hampton, because that no one else catches that.
Bremaugh for three.
Why not?
Another miss. Now the Shockers 0 of 10 from three-point range. Shoots. The basket will not count. Shoots traveled before the shot.
Well, I think Wichita State got lucky there because they're not getting the ball stopped. The ball's getting all the way deep in the paint before they get it stopped in the transition.
10-point Tigers lead, 5.5 remaining before halftime. You see the field goal percentage. Wichita State just 19% at 4 of 21. Not getting second chance opportunities. Tigers doing a very good job on the boards. Underneath to Davis. Davis.
Well, that was a great ISO right there. Davis totally had her man deep in the paint, way deep. And that was an easy assist.
And if Elena Davis establishes that kind of position, it's going to be difficult, if not impossible, to stop her. Now the other way. Davis well defended on the attempt from Smith. The Tigers on a roll. Jasmine Herndon with the layup.
Well, I think Coach Adams is fit to be tied. I really don't. You know what she can do to get him fired up here. Just need to hit a shot.
Bremaugh on cue, knocks down the long three.
Well, she's not gonna stop trying. And she's bound to hit one here sooner or later.
Bremaugh now 1 of 6 from three, 2 of 7 from the field. Makes it an 11-point game. And the other way, Tigers with a long two, courtesy of Jasmine James.
I think that's the best 3 minutes of offense that I've seen Memphis do in a while. Inside, outside attack.
Over to Hampton. Bremaugh able to track down the rebound. Bremaugh, another long three. Big rebound from Taylor Barnes. Still Barnes. Out of contact, no whistle. Ambrogio over to Hampton for three.
Yeah, I thought Hampton that time could have just gone to the bucket, and she took a step back and really didn't even have her feet set on that shot, so makes it real tough to make those.
Shockers just 7% from three, 1 of 14. Davis, double team coming quickly. And a lot of bounds, it will stay Tigers ball. So a timeout, we head down courtside to check in with John.
All right, well, a couple young teams here in this game. Memphis certainly fits that bill. The Tigers have 3 true freshmen and 2 transfers on this team. Here's our first trivia question for today. Which of the Memphis Tigers newcomers scored over 3,000 points in high school? Comment with the answer. You get the answer right, we'll show you on the screen later on here in the game for those of you watching along. So again, Memphis, which Tigers newcomer scored over 3,000 points in high school?
Thanks, John. I think I may have inadvertently given away the answer to that one. We will know if you were paying attention. We'll check that one in a bit. But a timeout. 3 minutes remaining in the half. Tigers leading the Shockers 29-16. We'll return to Coke Arena for the final 3 minutes of the first half after this.
This is our game, our moment, our time. We work hard and play harder. We stay loyal to the game and to our team. We are power, American power. The American, powered by determination.
Power comes in all forms, Power is a big tackle,
a big save, a clutch hit,
or a game-winning shot.
Power is also standing up for what is right.
There is power in the sportsmanship that is displayed across the American.
Power is respecting opponents,
officials,
student athletes,
coaches, and team representatives.
Power is not tolerating racial or ethnic comments,
profanities, or other improper actions while at the game.
The American.
Power for life.
The American. Power for life.
The American.
Power for life.
.301 remaining in the first half. Tigers lead the Shockers 29-16 here on the American Digital Network. And coach, the combination of poor shooting and turnovers not doing the Shockers any favors.
Yeah, they basically have Bremont with 7 points, but we need Ambrosio, we need Cabbage and Hampton and Baston to pick it up and start attacking the basket and scoring. Cabbage is a key to their team. She shot well last year. She's just not getting enough touches, so they need to start looking for her.
Stinson with the three, knocks it down. Great inbounds play, and Jada Stinson adds to the Tigers' lead. Taking a look at our Facebook question that John posed, which of the Tigers' newcomers scored over 3,000 points in her high school career? Correct answer to that would be Jamira Schutz. Schutz, the freshman from Brownsville, Tennessee, over 3,000 points at Haywood High School. Thanks to everyone who contributed, everyone who put forth a guess in that one.
I'll tell you who I really like right now. I like Jada Stinson. I like what she's doing for her team. She has an energy about herself. She has a knack for finding the open player. She can hit the open shot. She's energy. She's doing a lot for him.
Coomber knocks it down. Her first basket of the game. The junior from Illinois, Kiana Coomber, in the box score. And you mentioned Stinson leads the Tigers. 8 points on 3 of 5 shooting, 2 of 3 from three.
Kid, I think what I'm really surprised about is the margin of score. I mean, I never thought this early we'd have almost a 20-point game. I mean, I thought this matchup would be a lot closer.
Still 2 minutes remaining in the half. What do the Shockers need to do to close the gap?
Well, they need a sense of real urgency, and somebody needs to hit a shot. I mean, 35 points isn't a ton, so I can't say their defense stinks. It's more about who's going to step up and shoot and make.
Bremont leading the Shockers, 7 points on 2 of 8 shooting. She is the only Shocker on the floor who has made a field goal. Henderson has 1 point. That came from the free throw line.
There we go.
And there is Maya Brewer. Excuse me, rather, Asia Henderson with the basket.
That's probably the third touch from an interior player all game. So good look. Let's do more of it.
Brewer with the bucket, her first. Looking for Porter, pass stolen away by Reed. Reed will pull it out to set it up. Still Reed right at Porter, draws the foul, does Ashley Reed.
Well, she showed a couple different shifts in her gear there. She was in, you know, third gear and then shifted it and got to the rim, so nice take.
Ashley Reed, the junior guard out of Wichita Falls, Texas, by way of New Mexico Junior College, at the line. Keith Adams, second year, the head coach of the Shockers.
She lost some key seniors last year and had a pretty good year for her first year at Wichita. But their standards are pretty high, and I know her standards are really high, and this could be a rough season if they can't, you know, get things worked out here.
Under a minute remaining in the half. Shockers have cut it to a 15-point game. Defense!
Sometimes when it rains, it pours. And that just was just off the tip of her fingertips.
Stenson leads all scorers with 8 points. Shoots, still looking for her first basket. The blocking foul will be charged to Maya Brewer.
Yeah, I think if you said that they would have this kind of lead and Schutz wouldn't have any points, I'd be shocked. So it's been coming from a variety of reasons.
Inbound stolen away. Right back to the Tigers. Tied up underneath. Bremaw and Porter both had hands on it. And the arrow will give it to the Shockers.
See if they hold for that one shot or.
Wichita State looking for the final shot of the half. Underneath, and the foul will go against the Shockers. Maya Brewer with the charge.
Yep, she slid, got her feet set. Pretty good, you know, good charge. Beat her to the point.
And nicely taken by Brianna Porter. Now the Tigers with the chance for the final opportunity here. The three off the mark and out of bounds with just over a second remaining. And that'll do it for the first half. Memphis leading Wichita State 35-20 in the Shockers American Athletic Conference home opener. We now head down courtside to check in with John Kerr standing by with Tigers head coach Melissa McFerrin.
Coach, just 39 points earlier this week in a game against Tulsa, 35 in the first half. What was the key offensively?
Well, we're getting a lot of transition. I think our kids are aggressive. I think they're in a good mindset. I think we didn't like losing the other night, and I think we're coming in to try to get a win today.
How much can some of the outside shots you knocked down really help the confidence of this team?
No doubt. Jada Stinson and Kiana Coomber putting in shots. I mean, that's huge for us because that's what allows us to stretch the defense and then get some things inside. That's been missing from our game.
Thank you, Coach.
Thanks.
Kit?
Thanks, John. You heard Coach McFerrin. The outside shots opening up the inside at half. Memphis leads Wichita State 35-20. Stick with us. We'll have stats, highlights from the first half and the second half when we return to Coke Arena in Wichita.
In a city known for doing things our way, there's a university that's driven to do the same, to blur the outdated line between academic pursuits and active ones, not just to learn, but to experience, to create, solve, build, to explore and express, to lead. Because an education isn't something you get, it's something you do.
This is our game, our moment, our time. We work hard and play harder. We stay loyal to the game and to our team. We are power. The American, powered by determination.
Halftime here at Charles Koch Arena in Wichita. Between the Shockers and the visiting Memphis Tigers, we now take a look at the Players of the Week in the American Conference. First, the Player of the Week in the American from Tulane, Crystal Freeman.
Well, Krista Freeman is a big reason Tulane is 2-0. She's got 17 points and 20 rebounds on the last contest, 10 of them coming from the offensive glass.
Now the freshman of the week in the American from Tulsa, Desiree Lewis.
Well, Desiree Lewis has brought a lot of pleasure to Tulsa. They're 2-0, and she's a big reason why. She just came off a double-double. She's a strong physical player, and she's going to attack you off the glass and on in the interior.
We'll have our first half stats and highlights coming up after this when we return to Coke Arena in Wichita.
More than 7,000 student athletes rising to become champions in 22 different sports at 13 esteemed institutions across 11 states. 360,000 students and 2.6 million alumni rise up in celebration of a Power Six conference known as the American, powered by determination.
Dominance for a fourth straight year.
Wichita from 30!
Unbelievable!
And be able to celebrate this type of championship.
There's the record breaker. They are the champions of the American.
Strong in mind, strong in body, strong in school, sport, life.
The grind is 10% physical and 90% mental.
The mind is the power.
The body is the means to jump higher, run faster,
be smarter, and live longer.
There is no weakness when it comes to seeking help.
We are stronger together.
So let's talk about it.
A waterfall starts with one drop.
Change starts with one person.
The American is dedicated to ending the stigma related to mental health.
And promoting success through a healthy, powerful mind.
Promoting success through a healthy, powerful mind.
Halftime in Wichita. Welcome you back to Coke Arena, where the Tigers of Memphis lead the Shockers of Wichita State 35-20. Alongside head coach Angela Beck, I'm Kit McConico. Coach, well, for the Shockers, just unable to get things going offensively in the first half.
Yeah, they weren't able to take away their interior like they really wanted to. Had a few more turnovers than they should have, and just didn't have a lot of contributions from other people besides Bremont.
Coach, looking at news in the American, four teams unbeaten at 2-0, UConn, UCF, well, that's probably to be expected. Tulsa and Tulane, a bit of a surprise.
It's exciting to see the little guys coming back up into the emerging undefeated. And I think the power rating by the conference is getting better, too. And seeing UCF, a possible 9 seed, that's pretty big because now they've made their mark. And we've always seen UConn there. But now seeing UCF there, it validates us.
Speaking of the Huskies, they have three players on the midseason wooden watch list: Nafisa Collier, Crystal Dangerfield, and Katie Lou Samuelson. No surprise there. The Huskies, well, there's a reason they are UConn women's basketball, as good as it gets. Coach, Charlie Cream of ESPN, his bracketology update, two American teams projected into the field.
Yeah, that's great. I mean, I think USF too is a sleeper. They haven't gotten off to the start that they normally do in the conference, but they're obviously someone that you need to still look at. But we're happy to see UCF in the mix.
So some teams in the mix hoping to book their spot in the tournament. We'll take a look at the stats and the highlights from the first half when we return to Coke Arena in Wichita. Tigers lead the Shockers 35-20 at the break.
In a city known for doing things our way, there's a university that's driven to do the same, to blur the outdated line between academic pursuits and active ones, not just to learn, but to experience, to create, solve, build, to explore and express, to lead. Because an education isn't something you get, it's something you do.
Power comes in all forms.
Power is a big tackle,
a big save, a clutch hit,
or a game-winning shot.
Power is also standing up for what is right.
There is power in the sportsmanship that is displayed across the American.
Power is respecting opponents,
officials,
student athletes,
coaches, and team representatives.
Power is not tolerating racial or ethnic comments,
profanities, or other improper actions while at the game.
The American.
Power for life.
The American. Power for life.
The American.
Power for life.
This is our game, our moment, our time. We work hard and play harder. We stay loyal to the game and to our team. We are power, American power. The American, powered by determination. More than 7,000 student athletes rising to become champions in 22 different sports at 13 esteemed institutions across 11 states. 360,000 students and 2.6 million alumni rise up in celebration of a Power Six conference known as the American, powered by determination.
For a fourth straight year.
Wichita from 30!
Unbelievable!
And be able to celebrate the second championship.
There's the record breaker! They are the champions of the American.
Halftime in Wichita, the Tigers lead the Shockers 35-20. Alongside Angela Beck, I'm Kit McConico. Coach, well, Tigers impressive in the first half, except for the final 2 minutes, but we take a look at the highlights from half number one.
Well, their transition game was really working on all cylinders. They're going into the interior. Davis was big. She missed a few shots, but then they got some help on the outside by Coomer and also by Stinson. So Bremon, it was just all Bremon for them. Luckily, she hit that one. She missed a couple, but at least she was, you know, confident in her shot.
Carla Bremon is going to need help trying to do it all on her own, the freshman from Angers, France. Tigers in transition. That is where they were at their best. Here are the first half stats.
Well, I think look at points in the paint. That's number one, 18 points in the paint. But also turnovers that you don't see, or that you do see them. It's double the turnovers, and you can't win games if you shoot 21% and you double the turnover ratio. So obviously they got to play better all around.
Tigers shooting almost twice as good from the field, 38% to 21. We'll have the second half when we return to Coke Arena.
Bernie scores!
Three strikeouts in a row.
Dominance for a fourth straight year.
Wichita from 30!
Unbelievable!
And be able to celebrate the second championship.
There's the record breaker! They are the champions of the American.
Strong in mind, strong in body, strong in school, sport, life.
The grind is 10% physical and 90% mental.
The mind is the power.
The body is the means to jump higher, run faster,
be smarter, and live longer.
There is no weakness when it comes to seeking help.
We are stronger together.
So let's talk about it.
A waterfall starts with one drop.
Change starts with one person.
The American is dedicated to ending the stigma related to mental health.
And promoting success through a healthy, powerful mind.
Promoting success through a healthy, powerful mind.
In a city known for doing things our way, there's a university that's driven to do the same, to blur the outdated line between academic pursuits and active ones, not just to learn, but to experience, to create, solve, build, to explore and express, to lead. Because an education isn't something you get, it's something you do.
Welcome you back to Wichita. Start of the second half where the Tigers lead the Shockers 35-20. We head down courtside to check in with John Kurtz, who's standing by with the Shockers head coach, Keitha Adams.
Coach, down 15 at the half. What needs to improve most in the second half?
Well, we've just not hit shots. Our shooting, shooting 21% from the floor, and have really struggled shooting the basketball. So, you know, I think we've played harder in terms of rebounding. Our rebounding stat line's better than our last two games, but we've got to hit shots, make shots. We've just really struggled putting the ball in the hole.
How difficult have they been to defend in the paint?
Well, that's given us a little trouble. We got sealed down on the low blocks. We're going to try to mix up our defense a little bit more on make and miss. So hopefully switching up our defenses, and then we got to get putbacks and we got to make some shots.
Coach, thanks.
Thank you.
Kit.
Thanks, Sean. And Coach, you heard it. Coach Adams told you and I that it was about rebounding, and, well, her Shockers out-rebounding the Tigers 22-20 in total rebounds, but not making shots.
Yeah, not making shots is key. I mean, 35 points is not too much for a defense to give up, but they also got to get some stops, too, because they got to get back in this game.
So along with getting stops, obviously, that is something the Shockers need to do. They need to figure out a way to solve the puzzle that is Elena Davis there in the low block for the Tigers. What else do the Shockers need to do in the second half?
Well, I think mixing up the defenses like she's talking about is really what I was hoping she was going to do, because it's too predictable. I think she needs to get energy out of her kids somehow. And by mixing it up and maybe extending just a little bit more, maybe they can show them a look that they're not used to, get them out of their rhythm a little bit.
For Coach McFerrin, is it just about keeping the status quo, or do her Tigers need to make any changes?
Well, you mentioned that they didn't score the last 2 minutes and 19 seconds of that quarter, of the second quarter, so they can't get lackadaisical here. This is a Keitha Adams team that they're playing at home. If they let them hang around, it'll be a game. So they need to put them away, and they need to get their transition game going and run here.
Always a great atmosphere here at Koch Arena in Wichita. A great history of basketball for the Shockers. A wonderful place to be on a winter afternoon. Glad to have you with us on the American Digital Network. Tigers will have the opening possession of the second half. Did not score in the final 2 minutes, 19 seconds of the first half. Looking to remedy that early on. Davis underneath. The double team there quickly out for the three. Davis going to the floor and able to tie it up.
Yeah, I think Davis just needs to be chinning that ball underneath her chin and getting those elbows out a little more. She tends to, that's a good hustle play by her, but when it went into her originally, she brought it down to her lower level, and that's anybody's ball then.
Davis leads all scores, 11 points on 3 of 9 shooting, 5 of 6 from the free throw line, also 4 rebounds, and another turnover. That pass stolen away, well read by Jasmine Herndon, and turnover the other way for the Tigers.
I think mid first quarter, the Tigers started to get a little rhythm, but it really came from their defense. Their defense created their offensive opportunities, so they need to get their energy going up on their defense and make some things happen here.
Forced 13 turnovers in the first half. Bremont trying to go inside looking for Lasada Cabbage. And it will go against the Tigers. Ashley Reed able to draw the charge.
Ashley Reed, she plays hard. I mean, she gets up and down, and that was a great defensive effort by her. She's got that Lenox Hill on her knee. It's not stopping her. I mean, that shows a lot of courage by her and her leadership.
Reed, the junior from Texas, finds Lasada Cabbage with just her second basket of the game.
I've said this before, but I would like her to score more. That girl is capable of getting double digits every night. She just needs more opportunity.
Shockers looking for another stop, long three. Wichita State comes away with the rebound.
Well, that's an ill-advised three. They are getting it back with their defense, but ill-advised.
Shoots.
All right, there you go.
With the charge, Shamira shoots, can't believe it.
Would they reverse it?
We'll take another look, shoots. Now you can see the feet of Reed inside the circle.
Yeah, she didn't quite get established on that play, but I'm gonna give her an A for effort, for sure.
So Jamira Schutz will head to the line looking for her first points of the game.
Yeah, Schutz has been a little quiet. Sometimes that's like that ESPN thing where you give them all this accolades early, like we did here. She was a player to watch in this game, and sometimes you just don't always make it happen.
Yeah, commonly referred to as the broadcaster's curse.
Yes.
Spotlighting Jamira Schutz as the player to keep an eye on. She's 0 for 3 from the field.
But that's what a freshman does sometimes, that doesn't give you the consistency that, that she doesn't even know what's coming about. So, done an outstanding job so far, though, for them.
Leads the Tigers in scoring, almost 14 points a game. Top scoring freshman in the conference. Comes up with her first points of the game.
Well, love, love, love what they're doing on defense. They're double teaming a young team like this, and they don't like to be double teamed. And so now they've thrown it away twice against their pressure. So I'm going to keep doing that if I'm Coach McFerrin, extending my defense on them because they're not handling it well.
Looking for Davis in the low block instead, out for the three. Davis with the rebound. And fouled on the putback. Elena Davis headed to the line. Lasada Cabbage with the foul.
So far, though, in the second half, we've not seen him go to the interior. We've seen him shoot the three ball, which coach doesn't want him to do. Now, she happens to clean up, the rebound, but she's not getting the touch. And I think that they need to be a little bit more particular about the shot selection.
Davis, 5 of 6 from the line, make it 6 of 7.
Kit, she's got a good-looking free throw, doesn't she? And it's weird because she's not methodical on the post block, but her free throw looks pretty nice. Good follow through, good touch, good finish.
Hits them both, does the sophomore from Georgia. Back to an 18-point Tigers lead, 8 minutes remaining in the third. That pressure from the Tigers forces another turnover. They're gonna call a kicked ball. Coaches, you mentioned you see the pressure from Memphis and really difficult for the Shockers to break right now.
They need a little better court spacing. They made like 4 passes in a, 10-foot space. I mean, they need to get the ball reversed, get a little more depth to their passes, and be a little quicker with it. But when a guard brings the ball down against a trap, you're in trouble.
Serafini Bastin, the freshman guard from Belgium, back on for the Shockers.
Let's see if they get a 3-point shot or try to get it to the interior.
Outside the three.
Yeah, they're bound and determined to shoot the deep three ball. Don't ask me why.
Barnes with the miss, the Memphis native. Both these teams looking for their first victory in conference. Both 0-2 in the American. Tigers have lost their last 3, the Shockers the last 2. That one almost batted away as Herndon got a fingertip to it.
That's the first time they've been able to get it down to, past the free throw line extended.
Bastin knocks down the long 2.
And they need more of that. That's good offensive execution that time.
Herndon over to Schutz. Shoots back, thought about the three, instead.
She wanted it.
Underneath to Davis. He turns it over.
Yeah, she's a little bit unsure of her footwork. I think she wanted to pivot there, but was using the wrong foot. I'd like to see her square up first.
Knocked out of bounds. It will remain a Shocker's ball as we head down courtside to check in with John.
One thing Memphis head coach Melissa McFerrin mentioned earlier this week is the fact that Elena Davis has seen so many more double teams since she had such a terrific non-conference part of the schedule. In practice, that was an emphasis to make sure that Davis can deal with the double teams. And so far, 13 points today shows progress in that area.
Thanks, John. Six double-doubles for Davis. But it's been a tough start to the conference season. Coach McFerrin trying to get her back to the form that she had early in the non-conference, as John mentioned. Off to a good start here. In and out of the hands, Bremont just took her eyes off of it.
Well, I think the thing that Davis does, though, is she gets to the line a lot when she doesn't make her shot. Going 7 of 8 from the free throw line and having your big girl shoot that kind of percentage is always comforting if you're a coach.
And what a luxury it is to have a player like that. If she's fouled, shooting better than 75% from the stripe. 7 of 8 in this game. The Tigers with the turnover. Reed still, Reed hard to the basket, but can't get the layup. Out of bounds, good work underneath on the rebound from Raven Prince. It will remain Shocker's ball.
Yeah, Raven Prince, that was a good rebound. I'd like to see hers keep stepping up a little bit for them. She's capable. She averages 4.6 rebounds per game.
Prince, one of the leaders, according to Coach Adams. Lasada Cabbage with the drive and the layup.
Coach says that she gets frustrated with herself, Cabbage. And so, she's hard on herself. And that's kind of tough when you're a player because she wants her to keep her confidence.
Lasada Cabbage for three. That would have been big. Shoots with the rebound for Memphis. Shoots, takes it herself short. Out of bounds, it will stay Tigers ball. Carla Bremont coming off for the Shockers. Bremont 7 points on 2 of 8 shooting, leads Wichita State.
They like that deep corner. I think if we do a shot chart, there's going to be several circles down there. And it's surprising because it's right in front of the coach.
Tigers now just 3 of 13 from long range. Shockers 1 of 15 from three. You generally see them try to shoot that on the other side of the floor. Porter out, Stinson. On to Herndon, who draws the foul.
Yeah, Cabbage was inside the that little circle, so she's frustrated, but. Well, it's barely. Had her feet on the line, huh?
Yeah, may have had a heel on the line. That is what the officials saw. As Lasada Cabbage picks up her third, and that will send Jasmine Herndon, the junior from Memphis, to the line.
Herndon's having a nice game. She's silent, but, 8 points and or 6, 7 points, and she's making things happen on the defensive end.
Memphis 10 of 14 from the free throw line, just over 70%. Herndon able to add to that. 42-26, Tigers, 5 minutes remaining in the third.
What's hard for Wichita is they start their offense so far away from the basket. And it takes them so long to get into it. I mean, I'm looking at the clock, and it's maybe 13 seconds left before they're even getting it to the free throw line extended. So they need to find a way to get into their offense a little quicker.
Timeout with 4:49 remaining in the third. Tigers on top, 42-26. We head back down courtside to check in with John.
Another trivia question. Despite being one of the youngest teams in the country, Wichita State does have continuity on its roster as well. Which Shocker entered the year as the statistical active leader in 11 different categories? Is it Cesaria Ambrosio, Raven Prince, Ashley Reed, or Sabrina Lozada Cabbage? Let us know your answer. We'll get the correct answer later on.
It's John. And which Shocker entered the year as the active leader in 11 categories? We'll get you the answer when we return.
Power comes in all forms.
Power is a big tackle,
a big save, a clutch hit,
or a game-winning shot.
Power is also standing up for what is right.
There is power in the sportsmanship that is displayed across the American.
Power is respecting opponents,
officials,
student athletes,
coaches, and team representatives.
Power is not tolerating racial or ethnic comments,
profanities, or other improper actions while at the game.
The American.
Power for life.
The American, power for life.
The American,
power for life.
This is our game, our moment, our time. We work hard and play harder. We stay loyal to the game and to our team. We are power, American power. The American, powered by determination. More than 7,000 student athletes rising to become champions in 22 different sports at 13 esteemed institutions across 11 states. 360,000 students and 2.6 million alumni rise up in celebration of a Power Six conference known as the American, powered by determination.
Welcome you back to Coke Arena here in Wichita. Memphis leading Wichita State 42-26, 4:49 remaining in the third. Tigers, well, they've been taking advantage of Shocker's turnovers.
Well, 20 to date, and we're just in the third quarter, so not what coach will want them to do. And also, they've got Lasada Cabbage with four fouls, so they need to keep her in the game as much as possible.
Conversely, Tigers have turned it over just 11 times. Also better from the field at 33%, 14 of 42, as opposed to the 26%, 9 of 34 for Wichita State.
The same shot out of the deep corner.
Memphis now 3 of 14 from 3. Wichita State just 1 of 15, but they continue to shoot the 3.
I mean, I think if I was the coach, I would walk right down that and stand on at the end of the where they're shooting it and yell at them every time, don't shoot that.
And Coomber has had two in a row from that corner. Has been unable to knock down either. Reed.
If Jada Stinson's out there, I'm going to say okay.
Batted, and there's contact underneath.
A little extracurricular activity there.
Coomber picks up the foul as she and Prince battling for position. Coomber now with two fouls.
You don't mind that if out of your freshman, though, you know, she's showing a little emotion, she's playing hard. I don't really feel like that's a bad foul.
Sends Raven Prince to the line, the redshirt junior from Oklahoma City.
Yeah, Raven Prince just one of two. I mean, that's not a lot of looks for her, and she's got a lot in her tank.
And Bremont leads the Shockers in scoring, but no Shocker in double digits.
Well, Cabbage started to heat up, but now she's got that fourth foul, so she's not playing her.
Shockers with it after the turnover. Bastin driving in underneath the Prince. Bastin able to draw the foul before the pass to Raven Prince.
I'm like, yeah, let's go get it. Let's do it.
That's exactly what Serafini Bastin thought. She was taking it all the way, and that's good to see from the Shockers. Somebody who's going to take the onus, put this team on their shoulders. It may be the freshman from Belgium.
Yeah, I mean, taking that, getting as deep as she did, that's what she needs to do because they need to pick it up.
Still a lot of time remaining in this one. 3:51 into the third, an entire fourth quarter to play. The officials just checking to make sure call was correct. It was. Bastin now at the line.
They've got a pretty small lineup in right now. They've got, you know, 5'8", 5'5", 5'5". I mean, it's pretty little, so they're going to have to be scrambling.
Prince, the tallest of the Shockers on the floor, 6'1". Bastin hits the pair, and it's a 13-point game. It's been a long time since the Shockers have gotten this game in single digits.
Well, I think Memphis has helped them by taking those long bombs out of that corner and not letting their post touch it.
Shoots. Over to Stinson, now back with Barnes. Shoots, drives baseline. And the foul will be on Jamyra Shoots. And you see it right there. Memphis, 5 minutes without a made basket.
Well, that's a good combination of them doing it to themselves and Wichita stepping up a little more and making some things happen, taking a couple charges. So they're within striking distance now, and they just need someone to hit a shot. It's like they're running a specific set here.
Prince, high off the glass, the big rebound from Faye. Melissa Faye, the sophomore from France.
See, I was talking about Prince, and I knew she had more in that tank. She should be doing that. I mean, that's a great move. She missed it, but what a great drive.
You see it right there, going right at the heart of the Tigers' defense. Faye just unable to hold on to the rebound. Starting to see some signs of life from the Shockers. Shoots with the rebound and the putback.
Well, she wasn't going to have any of that. I mean, she's been a little frustrated tonight. That was a good putback.
Just the second basket of the game from Jamyra Shoots.
Run a little 1-4 high set now against this defense.
Bastin out to Reed. In and out, couldn't knock down the three. Bastin able to track down the rebound. And a newly energized Shockers team.
Starting to play with the heart that the coaches wanted them to.
Over to Peacock. Short on the three, but another rebound from Prince. Puts it back up. Jada Prince, the tough basket down low. And able to get down the other side. Stinson thought she was going to have an open layup. Prince.
Prince doing it on both ends. It all started from Bastin taking that early drive in the quarter, and now everything's kind of going their way.
All of a sudden, a 13-point game. A minute 35 remaining in the third. The Shockers get another stop and turn defense into offense.
Davis has had a really long rest, it seems.
Porter, the double team. Off the mark on the baseline. A lot of contact underneath. Porter fouled. Porter really battling in the low block, the senior from Nashville.
Yeah, she was hanging in there and even had her arm there. She went right back up with it. Good effort.
Coach, you're exactly right. We have not seen Helena Davis on the court in some time. How much longer will Coach McFerrin rest? Number 33.
I'm going to guess till the end of the quarter, but it's been a pretty flat quarter for them. if they can get Bremont in here and take a three, or you know, get a three, or if they can knock a three down here, it's going to be a ball game.
Porter, 3 points, 1 of 3 shooting, 1 of 3 from the line. Also 5 rebounds for Brianna Porter. Back to a 14-point game. Shockers have hit just 1 3 in the ball game. They are 1 of 18.
Well, I think now they've kind of eliminated that and started attacking the basket, which has been pretty nice to see.
They've looked better going towards the hoop. And on cue, Baston takes the three, unable to hit. Tigers slowing things down. Under a minute remaining in the quarter. Rudy White pulls up and hits. Rudy White, the freshman from Pensacola.
Well, they really like Rudy White. And, you know, any kid that gets a nickname as a freshman, I mean, you got to be something, right?
Melania Rudy White out of Pensacola High School, her first basket of the contest.
That was a high arcer, too.
Stolen away by the Tigers, looking for another basket, and they turn it over. Prince unable to get by James. James wisely just keeping her hand straight up. Underneath, Davis with the basket right before the buzzer. And the Tigers extend their lead to 18. 49-31, Memphis leading Wichita State. We'll have the fourth quarter when we return.
For a fourth straight year.
Wichita from 30.
Unbelievable.
And be able to celebrate the seventh championship.
There's the record breaker. They are the champions of the American.
In a city known for doing things our way, there's a university that's driven to do the same, to blur the outdated line between academic pursuits and active ones, not just to learn, but to experience. To create, solve, build, to explore and express, to lead. Because an education isn't something you get, it's something you do.
Back to Coke Arena in Wichita, where the Memphis Tigers lead the Wichita State Shockers 49-31. Ready to start the fourth quarter, but first we head down courtside to check in with John.
Rebounding was the biggest key, according to Wichita State head coach Keitha Adams coming into this game. The Shockers trying to sustain some energy to get back into it. The Jamaira Shoots putback late in the quarter really deflated the Shocker bench. And the shot at the end of the quarter there helped that some more again. Wichita State struggling to maintain some energy on the bench right now. The body language looks deflated, and it started with getting beat on the glass.
Thanks, John. Coach, when you and I spoke with Coach Keitha Adams earlier this week, she said there were three keys. They need to be better on the glass, which they have done in this game. They need to be better from the floor, and they need to limit turnovers. They've done the first. They are winning the rebounding battle, but they need to improve field goal percentage and turnovers. Take a look at upcoming broadcasts here on the American Digital Network. On Wednesday, Wichita State will head down to Dallas to take on the Mustangs of SMU, and then two very good ones the following week with Tulane at USF and UCF at ECU. We have USF and SMU coming up on Saturday, the 26th. So great games on tap for you. Hope you'll join us for all of those on the American Digital Network. Quick Tigers turnover to start the fourth quarter. Prince able to turn it into points for the Shockers.
Well, I'm so excited to see her really energized now. She's making a difference. Now they've got her up in the front of the press. I've not seen her extend that much, so this is a good combination that they're throwing some different defenses out.
Prince, the 6'1" redshirt junior, great athleticism, now putting her up top. We'll see if she's able to cause some more turnovers.
Yeah, she's got a long wingspan. Look at that wingspan.
Myers shoots. Just 5 points in the game. Rudy White trapped in the corner and tied up. The freshman from Pensacola.
Well, they're becoming less predictable now, the Shockers are, and they're giving Memphis a little bit of their own medicine by trapping them and getting two quick turnovers.
The arrow gives it to the Shockers. Trying to cut in to this 16-point deficit. Bremaugh knocked away by James, went right at Jasmine James, couldn't get by her, shoots the other way. We'll head to the free throw line.
Well, that shows the physicality of shoots. I mean, she's a three-level scorer. She can put it down, take it to the hole, shoot the little jumper. And her three-point shot is not as good as it has been. But, you know, when you score 3,000 points in high school, you know how to score. And she was taking that all the way.
She's led the Tigers in scoring in 8 games this season, the top scoring freshman in the conference. But shoots just 2 of 7 from the field, 6 points in the ball game.
I do like her mentality, though. She seems like she has like a junior or senior mentality where, you know, if she gets frustrated, you know it, but she's a tough competitor.
Rosada Cabbage back on the floor for the Shockers, playing with 4 fouls. And a nice little pull-up hits the runner, does Jada Hampton.
Well, they've figured something out, Wichita State has. They figured out how to penetrate the middle of that zone, and that's given them several good looks.
15-point game, still plenty of time remaining, and a Tigers turnover. Serafini Bastin into the front court to Prince. Lost the handle, got it back, and lays it up and in.
I'm so glad I talked about Prince's tank, because she's filling it up right now.
Raven Prince now 9 points, 4 of 7 shooting, and it's a 13-point game. 8:28 remaining in the ball game. This one's starting to get good.
In a city known for doing things our way, there's a university that's driven to do the same, to blur the outdated line between academic pursuits and active ones. Not just to learn, but to experience, to create, solve, build, to explore and express, to lead. Because an education isn't something you get, it's something you do.
.28 remaining in the ball game. Tigers with a 13-point lead. Memphis leading Wichita State here at Coke Arena. The home conference opener for the Shockers. Both teams looking for their first win in the American this season. Alongside Coach Angela Beck, I'm Kit McConico. And Coach, you've got to give the Shockers credit. They've changed things up here in the second half, particularly early in the fourth quarter, and it's paying dividends.
Well, they're mixing it up. They're making things happen, and it's energized their team. So they just need to keep doing it, more of it, and keep hitting shots.
Hitting shots, well, that makes everything better. The shot percentage continues to notch up for the Shockers. And, well, if that continues to be the case, we may be in for a very good one here now up to 28% from the field is Wichita State, 13 of 46, but just 1 of 19 from 3. The good news is they've stopped shooting the 3 ball and they've started attacking the rim.
Well, they're shooting better percentages now. I mean, they're finally at 38%, so that's better than what they were. They're at 20% half the game, so they're starting to get some good shots to go in, and you can feel their energy. So I watch out, Memphis.
Tigers with Herndon, Barnes, Schutz, Davis, and James on the floor. Shockers, Lasada, Cabbage, Bremont, Hampton, Bastin, and Ambrogio. Cesare Ambrogio, the senior from Switzerland. Back on, first time we've seen her in the second half. Back to the action.
Well, I think Memphis has to focus on Davis. She's their leading scorer. Good things happen when she touched the ball.
Davis, 15 points, 4 of 11 shooting. Also 5 rebounds for Elena Davis. Shockers starting to apply some pressure, looking to force turnovers. Davis had it stripped away by Bremont. It will stay with the Tigers.
Well, just keeping it alive, tipping it. Good effort.
Give Bremont credit there. Davis brought it down. That's one of the pet peeves of coaches, their post players bringing the ball down beneath the shoulders. Bremont able to knock it out. Looking again to Davis. Lots of contact, no whistle. Serafini Bastin into the front court.
Getting a little fancy there. That's too bad. That's one of those unforced turnovers that they really can't afford to have here with 7 minutes to go in the game.
That is the 22nd turnover by the Shockers, and just miscommunication. Bremont not anticipating the pass.
I'm going to say half of them are unforced, too, and that's what really drives coaches crazy.
Tigers looking to run a little clock underneath to Davis. Davis able to collect it, the basket and the foul.
Well, I mean, it doesn't seem like it's fair, you know? You just go into Davis like that and she just puts it down. I mean, that's a little dependability there.
Coach McFerrin has to be pleased the way that Davis has been able to absorb the contact. That was a point of emphasis for Davis in this one. He's done a very good job. Davis now 18 points, 5 of 13, and a very impressive 8 of 9 from the line.
Well, she's got, you know, six double-doubles this year and 10 career double-doubles, so she's capable.
Bastin looking to drive in cross-court. Lasada Cabbage now Bremont for 3 off the side of the iron. Lasada Cabbage with the putback.
Well, Cabbage playing with those 4 fouls has to be careful, but they sure do need her offense.
14-point game, just under 7 minutes remaining. Another miss from Schutz. Shamira Schutz now just 2 of 8. Bremont into the front court. Draws the foul on Jasmine James.
It's amazing how many foreign players come over here and are playing as physical as they do. You know, she's a very physical guard. She's not afraid to attack. She's not afraid to pull up. She really has a good mixture in her game.
Bremont, the 5'11 freshman out of Angers, France. And coach, is that kind of a new wrinkle in the European game? Forever the knock on European players was that they were skilled, but maybe not as hard-nosed as they should have been. That seems to have changed the last few years.
I think it has changed. I think USA basketball is a big reason why we go over there and win a lot and beat all the foreign teams. And so they had to change what they did a little bit. But they've always been good shooters, great passers, and have a lot of moves.
Earned it looking for Davis, just too far.
That's what will drive you crazy right there, because there's no need for that. They need to take their time, be patient, get a quality shot. It's down to 13 points. That's a bad turnover.
Good idea, execution lacking. And now the turnover starting to mount for the Tigers. They're 19th. The three made, just the second made three of the ball game, knocked down Jada Hampton with the triple.
Well, she was named to the all-tournament team at the Dual Desert Classic. She's led him in scoring four times.
And it's a 10-point game, 6:07 remaining as we head down to the sidelines to check in with John.
Another trivia question for you guys. Melissa McFerrin is in her 11th season as the head coach at Memphis. She's been all over the place, including the WNBA. Let's test your knowledge here, those of you watching on the American Digital Network and on Facebook. Which WNBA team was Coach McFerrin the general manager of? The Washington Mystics, the New York Liberty. Choices for you. Who was it?
Sean, Coach, I know you know the answer to this one. We're not allowed to divulge that just yet. We'll let you.
It's one of those two.
It is indeed one of the two. The answer to the previous question John asked about which Wichita State player entered the year as the active leader in 11 categories. That would be Sabrina Losada Cabbage. 11 categories, including games played, points, rebounds, steals, blocks, field goals made, field goals attempted, three-point field goals made, three-point field goals attempted, free throws made, and free throws attempted.
I told you, she's got game. Unfortunately, she's playing interior more than she really likes to face the basket. So with Prince maybe up in her game, but she's more of a four player than a five player. They really don't have a true big center. That's what they're lacking right now.
Coach, the Shockers come back to make this one interesting. A 10-point game, 6:08 remaining.
Well, I will say that Memphis hasn't executed well. They really haven't. They've taken bad shots. The posts haven't really touched it as much as they needed to, and they've kind of done it to themselves.
I was just about to ask you, Memphis having a lot of success in the first half, specifically going to Elena Davis down low. The double team was coming. She was either able to make the basket or draw the foul. They have not done that here in the second half.
Now, I'm going to credit Wichita a little bit because they're extending their defense and trapping them up in that wing. But, I mean, if you get a ball reversal, the baseline's wide open.
A lot of time remaining in this one. The Shockers complete the comeback, pick up their first victory in conference this season in their conference home opener. Well, the Tigers pick up their first victory in the American on the road.
Well, McFerrin talked about shot selection, and this, if you're ever going to talk about shot selection, it's right now. They need good shot selection. They don't need to just take a shot out of the corner. They need a good shot.
Memphis just 3 of 14 from long range. Shockers 2 of 21. Coach McFerrin looking on a bit more anxiously than she has been at any point here in the second half.
Yeah, she's standing up now. She was sitting down for a while. But she knows none of these are easy to come by. This wasn't going to be just an easy game, and it's turned out to be a good game.
Herndon able to get it out. The double team there on the baseline looking for Davis. Shot clock expired. Great defense from Wichita State.
I don't understand that. Out of a timeout, I mean, that's just weak execution.
And that will draw the ire of a coach. The shot clock violation is one thing, but coming out of a timeout, completely different.
So now that these guys have plenty of time to get this game back, but they need to have a little urgency.
Cabbage over to Hampton, in and out. A big rebound pulled down by Jasmine James.
Wichita State has had 3 or 4 shots almost all the way down and come back out.
Herndon the miss. Davis fouled on the putback attempt.
And if it's on Cabbage, she's out. Yep, she's out of the game.
That is the 5th and final foul on Losada Cabbage. Sabrina, the senior from Santa Fe, New Mexico, heads to the bench with 5:18 remaining.
Well, that's a big loss for Wichita State. That's a big part of their offense, but somebody else is going to have to step up.
Losada Cabbage finishes the game. They will be without her services for the remainder Davis at the line where she continues her impressive afternoon, now 9 of 10.
Yeah, just 5 of 13 from the field, but she makes up for it at the free throw line with 5 rebounds and 5 turnovers tonight.
Yeah, you mentioned Losada Cabbage, and what a huge loss that is. 8 points, 4 of 7 shooting, also 6 rebounds.
Well, all of a sudden, we haven't been watching it, but Memphis has 20 turnovers. They've caught up.
Speaking of catching up, back to a 10-point game. Shockers not going quietly, but time of the essence is there is less than 5 minutes remaining.
Well, they're in attack mode, and that was a great attack.
What a shot. Looks like she lost it. Taylor Barnes, the junior from Memphis, somehow able to retain possession and knocks it down.
Wichita is making them uncomfortable. They're just not, they don't have a good flow in their offense right now.
Bremont traveled.
I think you can get away with that in France. I mean, literally they do that little slide step in France, not in the U.S.
That's been a point of emphasis this year from the officials.
Yeah, it's kind of a frustrating point of emphasis. I understand we need it for the game, but sometimes we don't need it for the game. It's slow enough, and I'd like to, like golf did the adjustment. In how do you speed up the game of golf? I'd like to speed up the game of women's basketball.
Davis back to work. Now Davis with 20 points. Make it 22 on 6 of 14 shooting. Bremoff for 3.
It's almost like she's shooting that with her fingertips. I mean, she doesn't have the ball in the pads of her hand.
Bremont now just 1 of 9 from 3 collectively. The Shockers 2 of 23. Timeout with 3:53 remaining. Tigers lead 59-45.
Power comes in all forms.
Power is a big tackle,
a big save,
a clutch hit,
or a game-winning shot.
Power is also standing up for what is right.
There is power in the sportsmanship that is displayed across the American.
Power is respecting opponents,
officials,
student athletes,
coaches, and team representatives.
Power is not tolerating racial or ethnic comments,
profanities, or other improper actions while at the game.
The American.
Power for life.
The American. Power for life.
The American. Power for life.
.353 remaining in the ball game. Memphis has extended the lead back to 14. The Shockers without the services of Sabrina Losada Cabbage, who fouled out.
I think the message is pretty clear. Get the ball inside to Davis.
Well, message received. Davis underneath. Does what she has done all game. Now 24 points to lead all scorers for Elena Davis.
She slowed it down in there, too. She's like squaring up and got her rhythm down there. She was a little bit out quicking herself early.
Bring on.
That's just taking them too long to generate their offense here.
Over in the corner for 3. Another miss. James pulls down the board. Quickly up the other way, shoots wisely. Understands the importance of taking time off the clock. Oh, and a poor entry pass, again looking for Davis, but Prince read it perfectly. You head down courtside, check in with John.
Well, it's time now to name the MVP of the game. Those of you that are watching on Facebook or on the American Digital Network, we want to know who you think the MVP of this game is. So send us your MVP for this one right now.
Well, I'd like to see Prince get a little more active here. Get the ball taken off the dribble. I think Bremont's really tired right now, and she's just a little short on her shot.
Answer to our previous trivia question about Tigers head coach Melissa McFerrin. which WNBA team was Coach McFerrin the general manager of? That would be the Washington Mystics, 2000 and 2001. She was assistant coach there in 99 and at the New York Liberty previous to that. Shoots able to knock it down. It's been a slow night by shoot standards, just 8 points, 3 of 9 shooting. I think she will take that if her team is able to come away with their first conference victory of the year. Underneath, short is Hampton. Got it back and draws the foul on the second attempt.
Well, I guess Melissa McFerrin's plan to keep Davis out in that third quarter, get her a good rest, paid her some dividends here, because once she got back in the game, she's pretty much taken over this quarter.
What a game she has had. 24 points to lead all scorers. Just under 50% at 7 of 15 shooting. She only 5 rebounds, so it does not appear that she will pick up her 7th double-double of the season. But she's been an offensive force, a juggernaut, if you will, as Elena Davis.
It's always good to have one like that on your team. I mean, just bails you out in the times of trouble.
Davis just a sophomore.
Yep, Jeff Brightwell, I've worked with him several times. He knows everything about these Tigers.
Voice of the Tigers to Davis. Now 26 for Elena Davis. Jeff Brightwell doing a great job as always, and got to think he's been enjoying this trip to Kansas. Stinson shoots. Starting to heat up towards the end of this one, just 90 seconds remaining, and well, that may well do it. It's Memphis now with a 21-point lead. So, Coach, you and I debating Coach McFerrin's choice there to keep Davis on the bench in the third quarter, but she certainly knew what she was doing.
Yeah, she knows her play obviously better than we do, and I think she gave her extended rest to take over this quarter, and that's what they've done.
Coach, we mentioned it coming into this, how big this game was for both of these teams, both looking for their first victory in conference. Not just that, but you look at the upcoming schedule for both of these teams, they both have a difficult road coming up.
Well, yeah, every game's tough in the American, but if you can win a game on the road, especially after you've lost your first two, it's a big win. They're going to celebrate this win. Wichita, on the other hand, it's tough to build a program. It's not easy. So these are some of the pains that you get early on with all these freshmen, and she's got the foreigners in there, and you know, she's just got a lot of mix, and she's got to figure it out. But she'll get it done.
So
I have a lot of respect for both of these coaches, and they're going to get it done.
I was going to say two young teams, both with very bright futures. Some tough games coming up as Shockers will head down to Dallas to take on SMU this week. Memphis back at home to take on East Carolina. Asia Henderson at the line, under a minute remaining.
We haven't seen much of her tonight, but she's got the body and the frame to play big.
And just a freshman, 6'3", out of the Tar Heel State, from Hope Mills, North Carolina, Southview High School product.
It usually takes a big girl a little longer to develop, and you know, when they figure it out though, game off.
Barnes down in the paint, never a good sign. Taylor Barnes, the junior from Memphis, out of St. Benedict at Auburndale, now back on her feet.
Yeah, it looks like she's holding her knee a little bit.
Coach, you've got to think that this is the kind of win, and obviously this one not done yet, but with just 51 seconds remaining, you're assuming the Tigers are going to come away with this victory that can really propel them as the conference season progresses.
Yeah, I think for Memphis, they had a lot of good things happen. Not only did they go inside to their bigs, but they had some good shooting on the outside. Their defense dictated action most of the night. So I think Melissa can take away from this and say, hey, we're going to be okay.
And for the Shockers, Obviously, they've got to be pleased with the fight. Does Keitha Adams, what else can she take away from this game?
Well, I think Raven Prince is somebody she can take away. She should be a mainstay for them. I think she gives them a lot of offense. I also think Cabbage, you know, she started to turn it up, but she's gotten into foul trouble. I wish they could get another post in there and get her back out where she's more comfortable.
Put back from Henderson. Starting to come alive at the end of this one.
Yeah, I think Henderson's develop's going to be big for them. If she can get more reps with that kind of body, they need that.
Tigers take a timeout, 30 seconds remaining. They lead 68-50.
Well, the timeout with 30 seconds to go is just, you know, kind of get your subs in there, but also, I mean, that's a good feeling right there for her. They needed this win. Both coaches were talking about the negativity of the losses and how heavy it is hanging on them. So this is a good road win for them.
Both these coaches mentioned a positive momentum, trying to generate some positive momentum going forward. The Tigers have done that this afternoon. Again, looking for Davis, well read. Shockers looking to close it just a bit. Henderson unable to control the rebound. It'll be Tigers ball, 13 seconds left.
Hampton's gonna be a good player for him too. She's got a lot of athleticism. She missed that shot, but she showed us something there.
Both teams with some talent. Stinson knocks it down. And I was just about to ask, where's Jada Stinson? The sophomore from Kentucky was hot in the first half. Haven't seen her here in the second.
I think that's her first take of the half.
Stinson with the three to end it. The final, Memphis on top of Wichita State, 71-50. The Tigers pick up their first victory of the year in the American. The coach, a big victory indeed for Memphis. They go on the road, they get the win. They snap the losing streak. They have to be very happy with the result today.
I think they did. They played an overall great game. They played 40 minutes, which is they've been looking forward to, trying to play 40 minutes, and they shot the ball well.
And the Shockers, even though a loss, there's some positives and some young players that started to show themselves toward the end of this one.
We've got a lot to work around. It's just going to take a little time.
The final from Coke Arena in Wichita, Memphis. On top of Wichita State, 71-50. The Tigers with a big win on the road, a complete effort. Elena Davis leads all scores, 26 points, 8 of 16 shooting, and a very impressive 10 of 11 from the floor. Now head down courtside. John Kurtz joined by the winning coach, Melissa McFerrin of Memphis.
Coach, how proud are you of this team for coming in and getting a road win in conference play?
Yeah, I'm really proud. We've been struggling. You know that. Anybody can look at us, but it hasn't been because we really haven't been working at it. And I'm just happy for our kids because we had some bumps today, but we found our way out of it. There were a couple of times I looked at them, and they had this little glassy look in their eye, but we got a couple quick buckets. It all went away. I'm really proud of them.
What did you like most about what Elena Davis did today?
Well, I like the fact that late in the game, she scored those really two important buckets for us. You know, she struggles. She normally hits all of those baby shots, and she got down on herself a little bit. But at the end of the game, she made the one that I think really kind of made us feel comfortable again.
Coach, thanks.
Thank you.
All right, we've got Elena Davis now, who is the MVP of the game. Elena, what allowed you to have the success that you did today?
Really, it was just my teammates. They just kept passing me the ball. Like, I missed a few shots at the beginning of the game, and yet they still kept passing it to me, and that's what I love about them.
How much does this win help you guys confidence-wise?
It helps us a lot because we dropped two early, and we really needed those. So it's a good time. Like, we were really excited about this game, so we came in and we played.
All right, thanks, Elena.
No problem.
Kit?
Thank you, John. Coach, the Tigers talked about finishing inside, scoring in difficult situations, and they certainly did that today. That'll do it for us. Big thanks to our entire American Digital Network crew. For my partner, Coach Angela Beck, I'm Kit McConico. The final from Coke Arena in Wichita, Memphis Tigers on top of Wichita State, 71-50.